because I'm coming with new content, new performance. Go get and chill some with the same. And go and go eat me. I want to go to me. I want to eat me. I got my swagger back. Man, truth.
Queens tell the truth, say your prayers, hold doors, pull out chairs, easy on the switch.
Let's go!
That dreams come true, I love you and I'm here for you.
Just the two of us, we can make it if we try.
Just me and you, just me and you.
Listening,
I need you
to do a thing for me.
I have.
You see my baby, she didn't have to walk.
Yeah, I know.
I need you to bring her back to me.
346 minutes later.
Those eyes, I love it when you look at me, babe.
Okay, I've decided to finally intro my vlog before I forget, before I lose my train of thought at the moment, before I just end up doing something else and then I never end up switching on the camera to speak. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So people are now reporting that they're experiencing tongue swelling and a burning sensation in their mouths or on their tongues. So yeah, as I mentioned, I haven't spoken to you guys in a long time. And as we've noticed, although I haven't spoken tata, we've noticed that there've been a few changes in my life. So I wanted to talk about happiness. What is, like, how do you guys make yourselves happy, and what things do you guys do to make yourselves happy, or what habits or what lifestyle changes did you make to make yourselves happy? So for me, I think you guys have noticed now I have a car. So I had a conversation with my therapist about this. I do a lot of thought dumping with my therapist, and he was with me. Obviously, I was new, and where I am now and how I'm feeling now, the various changes or the various things I've been able to, the various changes in my life and all of that. What do you guys want me to do? Anyway, so I was having a conversation with him the other day. You know, I don't want it to seem like I'm superficial or whatever, but if I'm being honest, I think since I got a car, I've been much happier. And he was like, there's nothing superficial about what you said just now. I'm going to tell you now, having a car is nice. The convenience is nice. The experience of getting to drive yourself around places is nice. And that's like, I love it. That's me right now. I love it. It's not even about the convenience. Yay, this radio. Sorry about that. For me, it's not necessarily only about the convenience. It's just the fact that I actually love driving. Like, I love it. I love it. I love driving. It's one of those things where I feel like it's like my hobby. I was telling that somebody the other day, what I feel like driving is my hobby. I love it. It makes me so happy. Like, getting out my music and I just drive around. Even like my listening on a petrol, I may be like, not so my listening on like bin petrol, I may have like a bonaku because I go around a lot in general. Like, that's just who I am, that's just my personality. So, yeah, no, obviously, it's now elevated and I get to do it a lot more and when I want to because I have a car. But, like I said, petrol, I'm obviously a hella bonaku because of the fact that going around or whatever, it's not cheap. It's yeah, and petrol malitsing ane or gets a real. Kule ya mikile be itla like a 350, wana ane itla like a 410 or something like that. So, oof, yeah, it's a problem how long musa sengir. But yeah, but for now I'm managing. I'm not completely, I'm not struggling tata. But yeah, obviously I could spend less on petrol if I hokotsa movement. But you know, people always say, hey, you're excited for the first few months. After that, you just get so tired of driving. I'm like, I don't know. That's just you. It's not something you enjoy. I actually like really enjoy it. So yeah, this is one of the things that I wanted to talk to you about. It's not just what's this thing called, the car itself, it's the concept, I guess. Yeah, freedom in general, freedom, having a certain level of freedom in your life in general makes you happy. Howley, especially howley masaid, when you have a certain level of freedom, it really does enhance your general and overall happiness. So that's just where I am right now, and I just wanted to like fill you guys in, and I just wanted to encourage anybody that's just really been feeling like they're somewhere and they've probably been saving for a car and they're looking forward to it and all of that. Kere, my girl, when I'm rooting for you to finally get it, because after you get it, you're gonna feel it. Like, it's gonna all be worth it, and it's going to be nice. Like, what you envisioned, it's going to be that. Like, home on hand. Of course, I went on a few minutes ago, on all of that, but the freedom that comes with it is so nice. So yeah, I really am rooting for you, whoever's listening, whoever is feeling like whatever, and who is actually even thinking of getting their license, or who's working on their license, but that they are getting discouraged here and there by a few things because the process is tedious. push, and then after you get your license, push, so that you can get a car, because, like I said, the experience is 10 out of 10 for me. Highly recommend. Yeah, so as you just saw, I just got out of TpZee. I went to size 10 pakela le gore nika. I went to size 10 just now. I looked at the motor and my dealer, but they didn't have. Hey, wow, you don't exit. What am I doing? Something. I'm sorry, I don't know what's going on with me right now. Can I get a little stress? I got the motor and my dealer, and they didn't have, and I was like, you know what, fuck it. I tried buying go main mall because it's for my said Universal. But when I got there and asked her, she was like, no, I kiss it small. I was like, oh, okay. And then I was like, fuck it, I saw that Barikisa my dealer. Let me just get my dealer and make my own damn motor. Like, my appetite has come back, and it has come back in full force. Mo long gore ke batla gore a ke tsana kola beke dira mae. Ke dira mama re glebe khone beke. Atenge beke dira mae, ke dira bacon. Hey, ke ja. I also want to make pancakes. I haven't had pancakes in months. So I want to make pancakes. I get pancakes, I get mae, I get bacon. But starter ke my dila le motogo. Ateng motogo le my dila. Thank you.
Such a cute old lady. Interactions like this really warm my heart. So, what basically happened was that this morning ke phakele tsebo odi, a friend of mine na ne ba hitla the uncle. So ne ke tlo go mo ema nokeng. Tomorrow, Saturday, another friend of mine ko bole bole ba hitla the granddad. So I'm going to that as well. And yeah, it's just a lot going on. Packets of both. I woke up very early. I woke up at 3:30 in the morning. Ke o tsela gore yo a ke tsela me ke ta fana go thogela go feela, but there it goes.
Much later.
I don't want to.
I have a YouTube channel, so I'm doing YouTube things. Is business going well?
Yes, it is.
It is? Yes, that's lovely. Is who's Rico?
Rico is the name of the company.
It's just the name of the company. Yes. It's not a person in particular.
No, the word Rico means caged in Mexican.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Rico. Wow, I actually didn't know that.
Or Rica.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. What's this yellow stuff?
It's sour cream.
Oh, okay.
What, the yellow stuff on top of it?
Yeah.
Oh no, that one is chili. The white one is sour cream.
I've never seen the yellow sweet chili. No, you made that, it yourself?
No, that one is homemade actually.
Oh, you made homemade sweet chili?
It's homemade sweet chili.
Oh, you know what? It's fine. Oh, it's fine.
Thank you, ma'am.
Hey, thanks. Have a nice day, ma'am.
You too.
Okay. Rico's tacos. Thank you. In the canteen in the afternoon, we were coming back from Golesong. I wanted to try, but none of us had cash. Sorry, Husuma Sumamo. Modulate that I make regular cash. Yeah, Suma Suma. I said to say go pay. Imagine. Anyway, so I wanted to try it earlier, but none of us had cash. Actually, he tells a lot. I actually have cash in my bag. You sort of cash, I think it's okay. Horare kong magi let's get cash. It's a man. Payday ke mathata. But anyway, currently on my way to Harata's house, in all the way in Odi. We're gonna go and celebrate her birthday. I'm so excited. These are her birthday balloons. These are her birthday balloons, helium filled balloons for the birthday girl. One time for the birthday girl, one time for the So yeah, I'm pretty excited about that. Guys, it's our game. Oh wow. I'm actually quite excited for this birthday thing. Maya's already there. She was doing Horata's makeup. In case you don't know, Maya does makeup on the side. She does makeup on the side. Rico's tacos. Okay,
that looks so delicious.
Try it first. Remember that I don't know how much it was. Is it heavy?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Gosh, it's shifting bangs. Six.
So good. Hi guys, how you doing? Like this video if you want me to start my YouTube channel. Okay.
Until after now.
give Baarbs 10 likes on this video. 10 is too much. 5.
Mm-mm. I usually get more than 10.
Okay. No,
that's
10.
Not even like bragging. But okay. Like
10. Mm. And then I'll start my YouTube channel.
You should raise the bar. You should challenge them. Fucking like 30.
30. But 10. But 30.
Consistency.
I love it. I'm so consistent. My mom is even shocked.
It doesn't sound like you to be going to church for 4 weeks.
Not even sound when she actively sees me getting ready and then leaving the house. It's like,
that's good.
Are you sure you wouldn't much rather take your camp chair and like a cooler box?
Wow! Whoa! Yikes! That's
I mean, not like I'm a bad kid or anything.
Sure. But like, she just identifying that, whoa, this is a 180 for you. Yeah.
So, hey, Okals over there, they can't even see. This is how I love it, because now you get to remain like semi anonymous. Like, you're there, but they can't really see you. This is my former colleague, M. Buddy Gaho. You want to say anything? Yeah, okay.
Hello, people. I am. I'm not so sure how I feel about being on camera. I mean, it is a new thing, but we learn, isn't it?
Just your outline, so I don't think it's that.
It's my just outline. Silhouette. This is pretty cool though, like this little light situation, because I look like.
Like it was on purpose.
Yeah, but that time it's not. It's like, oh, there's the Puka with a mystery man on your YouTube channel. But yeah, this is exciting. I've been looking forward to this for how long?
So Gaba and I are going to film and also record. An episode or a segment or a feature, whatever you can call it, for his podcast. And it's going to be about daddy issues. So you guys know that I'm very, very passionate about everything daddy issues and how that whole situation affects the youth. At first it was mostly females, because I am a female and I can really only speak for myself, but now we're diving into how it affects males as well. So the youth in general, or not even just the youth, people, how people are affected and berated by the fact that they grew up in a fatherless home. Terrible stuff. Yeah, it's a whole epidemic. You know, I had to Google at some point the difference between pandemic and epidemic.
It's a whole thing.
You have to make sure you're using the right vocabulary. So pandemic is when it's like widespread, it's like the whole world, it's like the, because America is huge, you can say America has a pandemic. Yeah, maybe the states. Yeah, there's a pandemic going on. Epidemic is when it's like a small, like, it's on a smaller scale.
Yeah.
Long story short.
I'm gonna start recording now. Hello, people. Welcome back to the Equilibrate podcast, and happy new year, and best wishes and best regards and all that good stuff. We're back with a new sort of situation we have here. And I'm joined by my buddy, Deepuka. What we're going to be talking about is father issues, daddy issues, and the impact that men have in society and the void that they leave when they're absent in children's lives. And, you know, if you've listened in on any one of my podcasts, I'm sure at some point I'm going to say something really, really sad about dads. So this is something that's really close to my heart, just close to Deepuka's heart, being kids that have this void. And this is just it means a lot to us. I'm sure there's someone listening in right now that is like, yo, this is like facts. It could either be, and the thing is, I've actually spoken with people, Dips, and you know, you tell them that, yo dude, I lost my dad to suicide when I was 11, and they're just like, yo, that's deep. And the thing is, they still have their fathers.
Yeah.
And it can get really awkward when, you know, they're venting about their dads and they're just like, listen, man, my dad is frustrating me to no end. I'm furious. I don't know how to feel about him right now. And I'm like, okay, but, you know, that's valid. It's okay. It's cool. But, you know, there's also that part of me that's like, I wish I could be angry with my father.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But, like, I can't, you know, you're sure I'll have the feeling, but it's not like I can, oh, father, yelling at you because I'm a frustrated child.
I can't do that because it's awkward. I'd be yelling at no one because where is he? You know what I mean? And, you know, it's not to say that there's something wrong. Yeah, like, you know, yeah, sure, have your issues with, you know, your people and resolve them or make your choices or whatever, but it does. Yeah, you know, like, there's always that thing, the moment the word father,
So today is Monday and I'm a little bit disappointed on myself because I was supposed to like have started today at 5 a.m. But this weekend was really, really hectic if I'm being honest. I had funerals and then my sihua thing. I had a friend's birthday party and then last minute I decided to go to the meeting. Friday night was 267 with baby J. So this weekend was just quite hectic and I didn't really get enough rest, so I wasn't able to like meet some of the goals that I'd set for myself this week. However, I'm finally going into Jack's gym to go and pay for my month subscription. So I should be starting tomorrow morning. I'm gonna go and check out the facilities and then yeah, we'll be starting tomorrow morning. Had a little debate last week between whether I should go to Jack's or what is it called? Is it called Preemie? Sorry, what is it called again? Hey, you made a video about Nyalo Nile Batong. Jack's Lee. How's the name of the gym failing me? Yeah, Yonele. Oh my god, what's happening? Yako Airport Junction. But really, it's not good for me. It's not good for my petrol. It's not good for my mental health to go to Airport Junction every single day. I was just like, it's working. I know I'm just going to end up getting frustrated. Kore, already I have to conjure the motivation. And then I also have to find the motivation, yeah, gotta get all the way to Airport Junction every day. I was like, no, that's too much for me and my motivation. So I'm just going to end up falling short in the middle. I'm just going to end up like just not wanting to do it at the end of the day. One thing about motivation is that you should find ways of things being easier for you to do them. So if already you're dreading a task and then you add other factors on top like distance, it's very you're literally setting yourself up for failure. So I was like, I'm not interested in going. Like, I literally personally I go to Airport Junction like once a month because it's the other side of town. So imagine now me paying for gym there and then I have to go there every single day. I was like, no, it's not gonna work out. So I just decided that no, it's working. I know that Jack's gym is more expensive than, what is this gym called? You know what? It's fine. Yeah. So I was just like, it's a little bit more expensive, but it's just, if you think about it, the petrol cost of going to Airport Junction every day is like the difference. If I just pay the money, my diagex, it's a lot of land. Hi guys. So, I had a conversation in the office earlier with two of my colleagues, and I thought that I should perhaps end off this vlog with just sharing what we talked about. It's important for me to share it. Holy recent daga, holy recent dan. So what happened was, Nthatile study results is a JC. I just heard my colleague Google from being chatty to just being on his phone like, what? So I should think he was just like, oh my god, what's happening to the education system, the quality of the education was on and whatnot. So obviously he was worried for his kids, I should think. So yeah, it was like I said, it's the issue of JC. The results came out, and the kids didn't perform as they didn't perform well. Long story short, they didn't perform well, and it's a crisis. It's a crisis. It's a bit of a crisis. It's like, hey, there's what's happening. But obviously, we're gonna blame it on the pandemic and how so. We were talking about it, and I said this. I was like, JC has to say pele, but like, this is what I said, and I wasn't saying this from like a point of like what's this called? I wasn't saying this from a point of like ignorance or whatever. I then continued to share that I'm speaking from personal experience. So let me stop trying to quote myself like in the right now. Because 2012 is when we went to St. Joe. 2012, 2013, 2014, yeah, and 2015 then I went to BC. Yeah, so it was 2011. 2011, required JC, and in 2011 I obtained, did it do like a 2011 and a 2012 A, and I think 2012 I obtained a C in junior certificate examination form 3 Komasarabul. But yeah, I remember, let me just start even go standard 7 I got a B. Like I said, and I should think it's still the same. PSLE was one of those things where I don't necessarily want to say but A never packed you, but it wasn't particularly difficult, that difficult horo was a A. All of your friends got A's for PSLE, so it was kind of embarrassing how it didn't be for PSLE. Anyway, so long story short, I got a B PSLE. JC, I got a C for JCE, and I was embarrassed. Guys, I wanted to, hey, yo, we told Nikki a bit about how I felt, kind of bad thing, and then an old status that I posted on Facebook resurfaced. Like it's Mark Zagazagara likes reminding me of my old posts nowadays, and I love it. I really, really love it. I like seeing Hore Ngilebeke Balabala on my Facebook and just the evolution and of Dipuka in general. So it was a post and I was saying something like, I can't, I think I might have deleted the screenshot because I'd taken a screenshot, but I'll try and look for it. I said something like, guys, before anybody asks me, I was like, guys, before anybody asks me, I got a C, and yes, I feel terrible and I just want to cry bucket something. So it was terrible. I remember feeling so hurt. Oh, I was hurt. I was like, see, okay, fast forward, I was lucky enough because I think that was the motivation I needed. Not only the fact that I failed and I was like, you know what, I need to redeem myself, but just the pressure of people actually get like straight A's. It just gave me that push that I needed, and lo and behold, out of 48 points I got a 44, a 40 motherfucking 4. Yeah. And that wasn't even the cherry on top of the cake. The cherry that I will continue to brag about until the day I perish is that I got a double A star in double sciences. Sorry, not a double A star in double sciences. I didn't do no more but pure sciences. Like, I don't write that because like that was a recipe for disaster. So I wrote double sciences and I got a double A star. But this ain't about me. It is about me. I mean, it's a story of me, but it's more to motivate you. So let me stop. So and I really did. I did all that I could. I studied. I studied hard. I did past papers back to back to back. If anybody was to ask me to this day how I passed BGSE, I will tell them past papers. I read those things day and night. But I read past papers, studied past papers more than I studied my books back to back. My mom honestly was very, very supportive. She did all that she could. She printed the past paper that didn't see. And I also got tuition. Obviously, the past paper, sorry, did like the answer. So you have to also do them with somebody. So I also went to tuition. I also had tuition. So Dr. Na, my advice is at the end of the day, in conclusion, there's still, you're still able to redeem yourself after failure ya JC. Don't be too down on yourself. Ha longo rona le sibling wa longo ro kwa le JC and didn't perform so well. Let them know that this is not the end of the road. Please, I beg you, you will be in this position one day. Lo ena o tsaka ka khanya teng, jaaka ke tsaka ka khanya teng. You will honestly be able to redeem yourself. Just put in the work. What happens? We're crying for a week. Then all of a sudden, we're in form four. End of form four. And all of a sudden, last year, this I think, at some point at the beginning of the year, I was crying buckets because I failed. Home on a day, you're with your friends. Kind of this is the time where we start drinking alcohol, nyana, smoking weed behind the classes. Yeah, and you've completely forgotten that you're supposed to be redeeming yourself. So just remember the mission. Remember, have your fun, enjoy high school, but remember that it's the moment of redemption. I think it's the moment of redemption. Study hard. Read those past papers back to back to back. And if I'm being honest, guys, I don't know if they ever tell you this, but let me tell you, you do not have to write pure sciences. You don't have to write pure sciences. Don't do it. My advice to you is don't do it. We tell a star ya katsala alone. Anyway, double A star, nigga. Anyway, that's besides the point. What's the point, guys? What's my point? Yeah, my point is redeem yourselves, guys. If you need extra help, I'll also go to beyond the past papers, guys. I will also really, really advise that where you can get help, please. The Bible says lean not onto your own understanding. In this context, they mean lean onto God's understanding. Lean onto God because He is the one that really like knows your path and where your life is going to go. But in this context, we mean like lean not onto your own understanding. So seek external help. If you can afford it, please get tuition. If you can't, oh yeah, another recipe that has always helped me throughout my whole like school journey, high school and university, is and in general, for me, it wasn't like I do it necessarily always just for me to gain. I just end up really like good analyze. So it's very, very helpful. The smartest kids, sit next to them. So that's just all that I have to say, guys. That's the little advice that I can offer you. This is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed my vlog. This one is going to be a long one, I think. And I thank you so much for tuning in. Like I said, please, hello, Ronale, a sibling or cousin or whatever that's currently in the gutter, remind them that it's going to be okay. All these feelings are temporary. Thank you. For the people, but to buy me, people, but to buy me. Cousins.
Then big shout out to Mongolia, Mongolia, and support them.